Dear students, in the previous video, that is oscillations part 4, we derived expressions for potential energy, kinetic energy and total energy for a particle executing simple harmonic motion, and we have proved that the total energy is a constant at any point along its path. There we derived expressions for potential energy. We wrote like this: 1 by 2 kx square, and kinetic energy 1 by 2 ka square minus x square. Now total energy, that becomes this expanded this, and this gets cancelled, so that we get 1 by 2 k a square. K is a constant, a amplitude is a constant, so this is a constant. So in this way, in the previous video, we proved for a particle executing simple harmonic motion, at any point on its path, for example, let us consider simple pendulum. When you move its bob aside and leave it, it will execute oscillations around the mean position. Plus A, this is minus A. See, the bob is executing simple harmonic motion along this path, to and fro motion about the mean position. See, along this path, at any point, whether at x is equal to a, at x is equal to 0, or x is equal to minus a, or in between, anywhere on its path, total energy, that is sum of potential energy and kinetic energy, is a constant. So now, mathematically we have proved here that the total energy for any x value is a constant. Mathematically we have proved. So let us show this graphically. So to draw a graph, we need points. So here, first let us draw a graph for, see, first let us choose this as, this is x-axis. On x-axis let us take displacement. That is x displacement, and on y axis let us take energy. This is origin. Suppose this is plus A, that is maximum displacement, called amplitude. And here this is minus A. Okay. Now to draw graph, let us draw graph for potential energy. So for that, what shall we write here? Here x, and here u of x is equal to 1 by 2 kx square. First let us take x is 0, then here 1 by 2 k into 0 square, that is equal to 0. Now let us take plus a, 1 by 2 k into a square. Let us take minus a, 1 by 2 k into, in place of x you write minus a, again you get 1 by 2 k square. So now using these points, let us represent the points in the graph. First, when it is x is equal to 0, potential energy is 0. X is equal to 0, potential energy is 0. When x is equal to a, 1 by 2 k s k. So first, on the energy coordinate, let us show. Suppose here it is 1 by 2 k s k. When it is 0, it is 0, 1 point over. When x is equal to a, potential energy is 1 by 2 k s k. When x is equal to a, potential energy is here. When x is equal to minus a, then also 1 by 2 k square. When it is minus a, then also 1 by 2 k square. Now, we get the curve like this. We get a curve like this. So this is curve for potential energy. This is curve for potential energy. Similarly, let us draw curve for kinetic energy. So for kinetic energy, let us write here x here. Kx is equal to 1 by 2 k a square minus x square. Like this. When x is 0, 1 by 2 k into a square minus 0 square is equal to 1 by 2 k a square. When x is equal to plus a, 1 by 2 k into a square minus, in place of x you write a square minus a square 0, 0 into something 0. When x is minus a, 1 by 2 k into a square minus, here in place of x you write minus a. When it is squared it becomes a square and again you get 0. Now let us show the points in the graph. For 0, 1 by 2 k a square. For 0, it is 1 by 2 k a square. And for a, it is 0. For a, it is 0. For minus a also, it is 0. For minus a also, it is 0. Now, let us draw a graph connecting these points. This is curve for kinetic energy. Now total energy. Total energy is equal to 1 by 2 k a square. Constant. For any x value, total energy is 1 by 2 k a square. So therefore, you get a straight line like this. You get a straight line, and this straight line is for total energy. Total energy. So in this way, we have done. Now, looking at the graph, we have some meaning, some what the graph represents. See here, as the simple pendulum bob is moving from mean position to right extreme position, see in the graph, mean position to right extreme position, the potential energy is gradually increasing. Generally, when potential energy increases, when height increases, potential energy increases. Here also the same thing is happening here. See, suppose this is ground, suppose this is ground. As it is moving from here to here, the height is increasing from the ground. That's why the potential energy is increasing. Okay, so on the other side also the same thing. As the height is increasing, potential energy is increasing. So as far as potential energy is concerned, we got some meaning. Now let us go for the kinetic energy. Actually, according to the law of conservation of total energy, according to law of conservation of total energy, see, total energy is constant. Total mechanical energy is constant. That is, potential energy plus kinetic energy is constant. See, now let us consider the right extreme position. Right extreme position. At right extreme position, see, that is x is equal to plus a. At x is equal to plus a, what is potential energy? Let us see here. At x is equal to a, the potential energy is 1 by 2 k a square. 1 by 2 k a square plus. What is kinetic energy? At x is equal to a, it is 0. Is equal to 1 by 2 k a square. See, we can give some numerical value also. For example, 1 by 2 k a square is equal to some 10 joules. So here, 10 joules plus 0 is equal to 10 joules. So one thing we understand is, at right extreme position, this bulb is having only potential energy. Only potential energy. 10 joules of potential energy, and it has no kinetic energy. So to our common sense also, as the bulb is moving to right, its velocity gradually decreases and momentarily it comes to rest. Rest means velocity zero, and kinetic energy is formula is half mv square. When velocity becomes zero, kinetic energy becomes zero. That's why here the kinetic energy is zero. Okay. Now, as the bulb is moving towards mean position, its velocity gradually increases, and when it comes to the mean position, its velocity becomes maximum. So its kinetic energy also becomes maximum. So as it comes to mean position, its kinetic energy increases. Okay, let us see here. At x is equal to 0, potential energy, what is that? 0. Kinetic energy 1 by 2 k a square is equal to 1 by 2 k a square. So here writing numerical values, (10 joules) = (10 joules). See, as this is moving from here to here, see here it was having only potential energy. Its potential energy is 10 joules, kinetic energy 0, total energy 10 joules. As it is moving from here, a right extreme position to mean position, the height is decreasing, therefore potential energy decreases. But its velocity is increasing, therefore kinetic energy increases. So here, since the height is decreasing, and we take this level as P is equal to 0 level. See here, all its potential energy is converted into kinetic energy here. So here potential energy becomes 0 and kinetic energy becomes 10 joules. One form of energy is converted into another form, but total energy remains same. So in this way, the law of conservation of energy also proved. Now, so similarly, see here we considered the variation of potential energy and kinetic energy. With respect to position, now let us consider the variation of potential energy, kinetic energy and total energy with respect to time. For a particle executing SHM, its displacement is given by A cos omega t plus, okay, we are taking the initial phase. If you take, omega t plus pi. For mathematical convenience, let us take the initial phase equal to 0. Then x is equal to A cos omega t. And see, potential energy expression, already we see this is 1 by 2 kx square. So here, in place of x, if you substitute this, you get, see, now potential energy, the expression for potential energy is a function of time. So now here you can write T. Now, similarly, let us write for kinetic energy. So this is the expression 1. Now, kinetic energy means K is equal to half m v square. And velocity expression is minus omega, now to get velocity we have to differentiate the displacement. So x is equal to A cos omega t, velocity is equal to dx by dt. Displacement by time gives velocity. So, differentiating this, we get velocity. A is a constant. If you differentiate cos omega t, you get minus sin omega t. And if you differentiate omega t, you get omega. So, you got minus A omega sin omega t. So, here, in this expression, and in place of V, we substitute this value. So we get 1 by 2 m omega square A square sine square omega t. So in this way, we got expression for kinetic energy in terms of time. So let us write these expressions here separately here. Ut is equal to 1 by 2 ka square cos square omega t, and kinetic energy in terms of time. So here actually 1 by 2 m, see here you can write this as m omega square is k. Therefore let us write, this is 1 by 2 k a square sin square omega t. So here let me write 1 by 2 k a square sin square omega t. So this is potential energy, this is kinetic energy. Now adding these two, we get total energy. And in these two, the common is 1 by 2 k a square. Here cos square omega t plus here sin square omega t. And you know that sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. So you get 1 by 2 k a square. K is a constant, A is a constant, therefore this is a constant. So it means total energy at any time is a constant. previously you proved at any point on the path, that is at any position, the total energy was a constant at any position. And this here we proved at any time the total energy is a constant. Now let us draw a graph for this. On x-axis, let us take omega t, and on y-axis, let us take energy. Energy, this is zero. So here the phase angle is zero. Pi by 2, pi, 3 pi by 2, 2 pi. Now, first let us draw a graph for potential energy. So, to draw a graph for potential energy, what is required? The values are required. So let us draw here a chart for that. Omega t cos omega t sin omega t u t k t. Omega t value is 0, pi by 2, pi, 3 pi by 2, 2 pi. Okay, first 0, cos 0 is equal to 1 and sin 0 is equal to 0. Similarly, cos pi by 2 is equal to 0, sin pi by 2 is equal to 1. Cos pi gives minus 1, but sin pi gives 0. Cos 3 pi by 2 means pi plus pi by 2. Pi plus pi by 2. It comes in third quadrant. And in the third quadrant, cos is minus. So minus cos pi by 2, but cos pi by 2 gives 0. Here, sin pi plus pi by 2 is equal to. In the third quadrant, sin also negative. Therefore, minus sin pi by 2. Pi by 2 value 1, therefore, minus 1. Here, 2 pi means 0 only, therefore, the values we know. Now, ut, what is the 1 by 2 k a square cos square omega t? Its value. So, cos omega t value 1. So, when you substitute here 1, 1 square means 1. So, 1 by 2 k a square. And k t value. Here sin square omega t. Sin omega t value for 0 is 0. Here 0 square 0 into 0. So here you get 0. Now for pi by 2. See, for pi by 2, cos gives 0. Therefore, if this is 0, u becomes 0. Here, for sin omega t it is 1. Therefore, 1 square means 1, 1 into this, 1 by 2 k square. Now, for pi value, cos is minus 1, minus 1 square 1, 1 by 2 k square. And for kinetic energy, sin is giving 0 value, therefore you get 0 here. And for 3 pi by 2, cos is giving 0 value, therefore 0 into something 0. and sine is giving minus 1 value. When it is squared, you get plus 1. So 1 into 1 by 2 k a square, 1 by 2 k a square. And for 2 pi and 0, we have the same values. Because we complete one revolution and come to the our original place. Now, let us represent the points in the graph. First, for omega t is 0, let us draw a graph for potential energy first. For omega t is 0, potential energy is 1 by 2 k square. For omega t is 0, potential energy is 1 by 2 k. Suppose here it is 1 by 2 k square. 1 by 2 k square here. So for 0, it is 1 by 2 k square. And for pi by 2, 0. For pi, 1 by 2 k square. For 3 pi by 2, 0. For 2 pi, 1 by 2 k square. So, drawing the curve, we get right. So this is curve for potential energy. Now for kinetic energy, 0, 0. Pi by 2, 1 by 2 k square. Pi, 0. 3 pi by 2, 1 by 2 k square. 2 pi, 0. This is curve for kinetic energy as a function of time. Now total energy is equal to 1 by 2 k square. It is a constant, therefore you get a horizontal straight line. So this stands for total energy as a function of time. So in this way, see, now here, see, this is potential energy here from 0 to pi by 2. As the potential energy is decreasing, kinetic energy is increasing, so that the total energy remains constant. Now let us do this problem. A block whose mass is 1 kg. See, mass is 1 kg. Fastened to a spring like this. This is having certain mass. Fastened means tied to a spring. And this spring will have certain amount of spring constant. The spring has a spring constant 50 Newton per meter. The block is pulled to a distance of x is equal to 10 centimeters from its equilibrium. See, this is its equilibrium position. So, and it is pulled to a maximum displacement. See, this is maximum displacement. How much? 10 centimeters. It is maximum from its equilibrium position. Calculate the kinetic, potential and total energies of the block. So find potential energy, kinetic energy and total energy at x is equal to 5 centimeters when it is 5 centimeters away from the mean position. So displacement, at this displacement, these three values are asked. So now for potential energy, the expression is 1 by 2 kx square. K value 50 and displacement is 0.05 meter. So we get the value 0.0125 joules. Similarly, kinetic energy. The expression for kinetic energy is this. So here the amplitude is 10 centimeters, that is 0.1 meter. So 1 by 2 into K value 50, capital A 0.1 square minus X value 0.05 square, that gives the kinetic energy. So here we get 0.19 joules. Now total energy. It is a sum of potential energy and kinetic energy. That is equal to 0.0125 plus 0.19. 5 to 0.2 joules. So here we get 0.625 joules, and here 0.0625 plus 0.19, 0.2525 are taking up to two decimal points, 0.25.